Our incubator's working. There were some eggs that were under that guinea from a couple of days ago that didn't hatch. So we put them in our incubator along with some others. And we've had several hatch. Nana says she's got 10 up there, you said. We just got two more out of there. Here's a little guinea keek, just fresh out of the incubator. The kids have some too. Show us what you got. There's another guinea keek. And here's a chick. These are just barnyard mix. So we've got Rhode Island Red and Dominique. And
Buff Orpingtons.
And Buff Orpingtons. Thought you might enjoy that. Here's a little guinea keet. Can't get much cuter than a newborn keet, can you? I don't know. It's been about a month ago or so that we moved this incubator into this shed. Papa bought this incubator a few years ago and he had some work whenever he bought it. It's a really quite nice incubator. It can hatch up to, what, 1,500 eggs?
It's supposed to hold 1,500 eggs. I don't know. I've never had near that many in it. We've got a little over 300 in it now, 320, I think.
It's a very high quality incubator and it does a good job. You can turn all the eggs at once, right?
Yes.
We've got it in here and we put some eggs in there on May 28th. This is early June and they're gonna hatch very soon. The incubation period for chickens is 21 days.
21 days.
It's 21 days, so.
And we've already had one hatch. It may have been
sat on
a little bit before we put it in the incubator, but we had one hatch early this morning.
But anyway, we've got this incubator in here and we're gonna raise chickens, and we're doing that for our own benefit because we like to eat chickens, we like to raise have our own eggs, but also because right now they're a hot commodity. You can sell them pretty easily and quickly. You get a whole lot more bang for your buck when you sell chicks for $3 or so each than selling a dozen eggs for $2, yes. Right? There is a little electricity involved. There is the startup to, having the incubators, but these are just a barnyard mix, and I think we can get to $3. Is that what we're going to try to get for
them? Probably. Straight run mixed breed.
But it's pretty exciting to see that this egg, this embryo, has turned into a little baby chick, the little fluffy, cute baby chick. And we wanted to share that with you. So Papa he did the goat cam before. If you watched the goat cam, he took care of all that. He enjoys this. He uses a program called OBS. He uses an IP cam.
It's a security camera, basically, that we had put up at another place that we own, and I'm taking it down, and I've retasked that camera. I've got it in the incubator all set up.
We're going to do a live stream. We'll probably start that tonight. We've already had one hatch and we've had one pip. They're due to hatch in 3 days, but we already had one hatch yesterday and one was pipped yesterday when we last looked at it. We're gonna go ahead and start it tonight.
It's in there chugging away. It's been holding temperature real good, and I've had it for probably 4 or 5 years now, and I've hatched a lot of birds in it. It's designed to have about 6 or 7 of them side by side. They've got these rods and they all screw together, and there's a big turning machine that turns all the eggs and all the incubators at once, but I don't have that, so I just pull them in and out by hand. The eggs will roll and rattle. You see the inside of it, you'll see what I mean, but I can't turn it because I've got a light in there so that you'll be able to see the eggs real good when they hatch. I keep water up here because there's no water in here, and I've got water inside, and I keep that filled so the humidity will stay up. There's a big fan that circulates the air, and when it opened the door, the thermostat kicked on, and you probably heard it click. And these the eggs lay in these little trays. And when you turn them, they all turn like this and like that when you pull that rod in and out. The water is in this. The reason it's up there, it's just sitting on. Originally, it was designed to be at the bottom, but we had birds hatch and fall in the water and drown. So we put the water up in an oil changing pan that comes from Dollar Tree, and it's just sitting in one of the turning trays because we don't use all of them. There's room for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 turning trays, and then there's room for 4 hatching trays. And we've got the trays. We've got all the trays. One of them is broke,
one of the turning trays is broke. As a matter of fact, it's this one right here. See, it's broke, but we've never had it come full of eggs. We've got an antenna mounted on the outside of the building, and this wire goes to it. I had to buy that. It cost $12 on Amazon. Everything else I already have.
I've not had any experience with incubators at all, but they've hatched lots and lots of eggs, as you've heard, and you're going to get to see some of those things and see some of the ins and outs. We'll have more updates and we'll show you more things later, but if you want to watch these hatch, if you have some free time and you just want to tune in the live stream, then you're more than welcome to. It's going to be on YouTube at Copperhead Road Homestead, my channel. I'd love for you to watch that if you want to, and we're going to start that tonight.
We'll keep it up running, and you can back them up. If you see one that has hatched, you can back it up and watch it hatch if you want to do that.
And if you like things like this and you like the things that we do on our channel, then you can like my page on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, check us out, comment below. We do want to hear what you have to say. It really does help us, and we want to hear. I read every comment that I can find. Like it and share it and do all those good things. We appreciate you very much. Come back again tomorrow.
Bye-bye.